Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the solution and discussion on the GATE question paper in Mechanical Engineering subjects. And this is lecture number 22. We are going to discuss few questions on steam turbine from various GATE question papers. And these are all the books I published: Design of Transmission System, Turbo Machines, Heat and Mass Transfer, Operations Research, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion, Thermal Engineering, Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the subjects mentioned here, also the video lectures on the solution on the GATE question paper for the benefit of mechanical engineering students. You please subscribe the channel and use the video for your better learning and to pass in the GATE examination. It is a free of cost. And the first question from the 1998 question paper: a Curtis stage, Rateau stage and 50% reaction stage is the in a steam turbine are examples of. There are four options given: different types of impulse turbine, different types of reaction stages, a simple impulse turbine, a velocity compounded impulse turbine and a reaction stage, a velocity compounded impulse stage, a pressure compounded impulse stage and a reaction stage. So a Curtis turbine is a velocity compounded impulse turbine, Rateau stage is the pressure compounded impulse stage and the 50% reaction turbine is a reaction turbine. So the correct answer is option D, a velocity compounded impulse stage, a pressure compounded impulse stage and a reaction stage. The next question is from 2000 question paper: which of the following is a pressure compounded turbine? So the answer is Rateau turbine. The next question is from 2001 question paper: Rateau turbine belongs to the category of. Four options are given: pressure compounded turbine, reaction turbine, velocity compounded turbine and radial flow turbine. The correct answer is pressure compounded turbine. The next question from 2003 question paper: considering the variation of static pressure and absolute velocity in an impulse steam turbine across one row of moving blade, there are four options given: both pressure and velocity decreases, pressure decreases but velocity increases, pressure remains constant while velocity increases, pressure remains constant while velocity decreases. So in the impulse turbine, so pressure decreases only in the nozzle, across the moving blade the pressure remains constant and the velocity decreases. The correct option is option D, pressure remains constant while velocity decreases. The next question is from 2018 question paper: select the correct statement for 50% reaction turbine. There are four options: option A, the rotor blade is symmetric; option B, the stator blade is symmetric; option C, the absolute inlet flow angle is equal to the absolute exit flow angle; option D, the absolute exit flow angle is equal to inlet angle of the rotor. So absolute inlet flow angle is alpha, absolute exit flow angle is beta. Absolute exit flow angle is beta. Inlet angle of the rotor is theta. Now, for 50% reaction turbine, so Vf1 equal to Vf2, the conditions are Vf1 equal to Vf2 equal to Vf, V1 equal to Vr2, V2 equal to Vr1, phi equal to alpha, theta equal to beta. Phi is the moving blade outlet angle, alpha is the absolute angle at the inlet, theta is the moving blade inlet angle, and beta is the absolute angle at the exit. So the correct option is option D, absolute exit angle, exit flow angle is equal to the inlet angle of the rotor. So theta equal to beta. That is the correct option. The next question is from 1991 question paper: the velocity compounded steam turbine is known as Curtis or Rateau turbine, uses the principle of converting entire dash pressure or velocity energy before entering the first runner itself. So velocity compounded steam turbine is known as Curtis turbine, which uses the principle of converting entire pressure fresh energy before entering the first runner. So converting, it is completely converting pressure into velocity, then velocity is used in the different stages. That is what the velocity compounded turbine. Next question is from 1992 question paper. The steam turbine operating with less moisture is dash more or less efficient, dash less or more prone to the blade damage. The steam turbine operating with less moisture is more efficient and less prone to the blade damage. So when the steam enters with the superheated steam, so less moisture with the superheated steam or higher dryness fraction, it will be more efficient. And when you have high quality steam at the entry of the turbine, so the blade damage will be less. Match the following. So list A, list 1, Curtis turbine, Rateau turbine, Keplon turbine, Francis turbine. List 2, 1 reaction turbine, 2 gas turbine, 3 velocity compounded, 4 pressure compounded, 5 impulse water turbine, 6 axial turbine, 7 mixed flow turbine and 8 centrifugal pump. There are 4 options given: P2, Q1, R7, S6, P6, Q3, R4, S4, P4, Q1, R6, S2, P3, Q4, R6, S7. We try one by one. P2, Curtis turbine is a velocity compounded turbine. So, P3 is the correct option. So, P3, first 3 is not P3. So, last one is P3. So, Curtis turbine is velocity compounded. We will check next condition. Q4, Rateau turbine is the pressure compounded, 4 pressure compounded. R6, Keplon turbine is the axial turbine. And S7, Francis turbine is a mixed flow turbine. So, the correct option is P3, Q4, R6, S7. That is the correct option. Option D. The next question is from 2005 question paper. So, in the velocity diagram shown below, U is the blade velocity, C is the absolute velocity, W is the relative velocity and the subscript 1 and 2 refer to the inlet and the outlet. So, the velocity triangle, it shows an impulse turbine, a reaction turbine, a centrifugal pump and axial flow compressor. So, this is the velocity triangle of an impulse turbine. The next question is from 1994 question paper. For a single stage impulse turbine with rotor diameter 2 meter and the speed 3000 rpm, when the nozzle angle is 20 degree, the optimum velocity of the steam, there are 4 options given: 334 meters per second, 356 meters per second, 668 meters per second and 711 meters per second. So, we are given diameter of the rotor, speed of the rotor and the nozzle angle, we have to calculate optimum speed of the steam. And we calculate. So, blade speed equal to pi dn by 60. So, pi into 2 into 3000 divided by 60 equal to 314 meters per second. Optimum velocity of the steam, sigma equal to Vb by V equal to cos alpha by 2. So, cos 20 by 2 equal to 0.47. So, velocity of the steam, V equal to 314 divided by 0.47. equal to 668 meters per second. So, the correct answer is 668 meters per second, optimum velocity of the steam. The next question is from 1997 question paper. The following data pertain to a single stage impulse turbine, nozzle angle 20 degree, blade velocity 200 meters per second, relative steam velocity at the entry 350 meters per second, blade angle at the inlet 30 degree, blade angle at the exit 25 degree, the blade friction is neglected, the work done per kg of the steam 124 kilojoules, 164 kilojoules, 169 kilojoules and 174 kilojoules. So, we are given alpha equal to 20, Vb equal to 200 meters per second, Vr1 equal to Vr2 equal to 350 meters per second, theta equal to 30 degree and phi equal to 25 degree, blade angle at exit. Now, the answer is 124 kilojoules. So, we will see how. So, this is the inlet and the exit velocity triangle of the steam turbine, impulse steam turbine. So, we are given alpha equal to 20, Vb blade velocity is 200 meters per second, Vr1 equal to Vr2 equal to 350 meters per second, inlet angle theta equal to 30 degree, phi equal to 25 degree and we calculate cos theta plus cos phi. So, cos theta equal to Vw1 minus Vb divided by Vr1, cos phi equal to Vw2 plus Vb divided by Vr2. So, we know Vr1 equal to Vr2. So, cos 30 plus cos 25 equal to, denominator is the same. Numerator minus VB plus VB getting cancelled. So, VW1 plus VW2 divided by VR1 equal to VW1 plus VW2 divided by 350. So, VW1 plus VW2 equal to 350 into 0.866 plus 0.906 equal to 620.2 meters per second. Now, the work done per kg of the steam, W equal to VB into VW1 plus VW2. So, 200 into 620.2 equal to 124040 joules per kilogram or 124 kilojoules per kilogram. That is the answer to the problem. Next question is from 2009 question paper. The inlet and the outlet condition of a steam of an adiabatic turbine, steam turbine, are as indicated in the figure. The notations are as usually followed. H1 equal to enthalpy, H1 equal to 3200 kilojoules per kilogram. Velocity V1 equal to 160 meters per second. Z1 equal to 10 meter, pressure P1 equal to 3 megapascal, at the outlet enthalpy H2 equal to 2600 kilojoules per kilogram, velocity V2 equal to 100 meters per second, Z2 equal to 6 meters and P2 equal to 70 kilopascal. There are two questions connected with this problem. First question, if the mass flow rate of the steam through the turbine is 20 kilograms per second, the power output of the turbine in megawatt is, there are four options given, 12.157, 12.941, 168.001, 168.785. The correct answer is 12.157 megawatt. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, for a steam turbine, so the inlet data, outlet data are given from the steady flow energy equation. M into G Z1 plus 1 by 2 V1 square plus H1 plus Q equal to M into G Z2 plus 1 by 2 V2 square plus H2 plus W. So, for rearranging for adiabatic turbine, so there is no heat transfer, Q is deleted. So, rearranging, W equal to M into G into Z1 minus Z2 plus 1 by 2 V2 square minus V1 square plus H1 minus H2. So, substitute numerical values, W equal to 20 into 9.81 into 10 minus 6 plus 1 by 2 into 160 square minus 100 square plus 3200 minus 2600 into 1000. So, convert kilojoules into kilogram. So, calculating W equal to 12.156 into 10 power 6 watts or 12.156 megawatt. That is the answer to the problem. The next, the continuation to the problem. So, in the assuming the above turbine to be part of the simple Rankine cycle, the density of the water at the inlet of the pump is equal to 1000 kilograms per meter cube. Ignoring the kinetic and potential energy effect, the specific work in kilojoules per kilogram supplied to the heat pump is 0.293 kilojoules per kilogram, 0.351, 2.93 and 3.51. So, we calculate the pump work, Wp equal to small Vf, specific volume of the fluid into delta P. So, we are given density of the water is 1000 kilograms per meter cube. So, density specific volume is 1.001, 1 by density 0.001 into 3000 minus 70. That is delta P, pressure drop between the turbine and the pump is, across the pump is 3000 minus 70 equal to 2.93 kilojoules per kilogram. That is the answer, 2.93 kilojoules per kilogram. That is the pump work required. Next question is from 2014 question paper. At an inlet of an axial impulse turbine rotor, the blade linear speed is 25 meters per second and the magnitude of absolute velocity is 100 meters per second. And the angle between them is 25 degree as shown in the figure. The relative velocity remains constant, remains the same between inlet and the outlet velocity triangle as shown in the figure. And assuming no losses, the specific work is in kilojoules per kilogram is dash. And this is the velocity triangle of an impulse turbine. So, we redraw the diagram with the proper notation. So, absolute velocity V1 equal to 100 meters per second. And this VR1, 78 meters per second equal to VR1, and this angle is 25 degree is the alpha, nozzle angle. And here VR1 equal to VR2, so VR2 equal to 78 meters per second, and this 58.6 meters per second equal to the V2. Now, this is the combined velocity triangle for the rotor of an impulse turbine, and the absolute velocity, it has got the axial component and the tangential component. So, the tangential component is not shown here, VW1 and VF1. And similarly, this V2 has got the absolute velocity, the absolute velocity V2 has got the component, axial velocity VF2 and the tangential velocity VW2. So this is the combined velocity triangle with all velocity vector and angles. Now we redraw, we take the diagram. Once again we take the diagram, we calculate VW1 equal to V1 cos alpha. The same notations, same calculation we are going to do, but it is a combined diagram. That is the only difference. So VW1 equal to V1 cos alpha, which is 100 into cos 25 equal to 90.63 meters per second. VF1 equal to V1 sin alpha, which is 100 into sin 25 equal to 42.26 meters per second. For frictionless flow, VF1 equal to VF2 equal to 42.26 meters per second. And we calculate. So we have VF2 and VW2 we calculate. V2 is also 58.6 meters per second. So from the Pythagoras theorem, VW2 equal to square root of V2 square minus VF2 square, which is square root of 58.6 square minus 42.26 square equal to 40.6 meters per second. Now we calculate the work done. So work done equal to W equal to VB into VW1 plus VW2. So 25 into 90.63 plus 40.6 equal to 3280, which is 3.28 kilojoules per kilogram. So this is the power output of the turbine. The next question is from 1993 question paper. In a single stage single row impulse turbine, the steam is entering at a velocity of 1200 meters per second with a nozzle angle of 20 degree and leaving the blade axial direction. The ratio of the blade velocity to the tangent velocity is 0.6. Ratio of blade velocity to the tangent velocity is 0.6. Sketch the velocity diagram and calculate the work output. So the given data, V1 equal to 1200 meters per second, alpha equal to 20 degree, VW2 equal to 0 for axial discharge, VB by VW1. So blade velocity to the tangent velocity is 0.6. So this is the inlet velocity triangle and the outlet velocity triangle. For axial discharge, so the outlet velocity triangle beta equal to 90 degree, V2 equal to VF2 and VW2 equal to 0. And we calculate VW1, V1 cos alpha, 1200 into cos 20 equal to 1127.6 meters per second. VB equal to 0.6 into VW1. So, because VB by VW1 equal to 0.6. So, VB equal to 0.6 into VW1. So, 0.6 into 1127.6 equal to 676.56 meters per second. Now, we calculate the work output. So, the general expression for work output equal to W equal to VB into VW1 plus VW2. For axial discharge here, VW2 equal to 0. So, W equal to VB into VW1. So, 676.56 into 1127.6 calculating 762 into 10 power 3 joules per kilogram. That is the answer. Or 762 kilojoules per kilogram is the answer to the problem. Next question is from 2000 question paper. A simple impulse turbine expands steam frictionlessly from 12 bar 250 degree Celsius with an enthalpy of 2935 kilojoules per kilogram to an enthalpy of 2584 kilojoules per kilogram at the point 1 bar. Assuming that nozzle makes an angle of 20 degree with a blade motion and that the blades are symmetrical, that is the condition, blades are symmetrical. Find the blade velocity that produces maximum efficiency for the turbine speed of 3000 revolutions per minute. Assume that the steam enters the nozzle with negligible velocity. So, we are given P1 equal to 12 bar, T1 equal to 250 degrees Celsius, H1 equal to 2935 kilojoules per kilogram, P2 equal to 0.1 bar, H2 equal to 2584 kilojoules per kilogram, nozzle angle is 20 degree and the blade is symmetrical. For symmetrical blading in the impulse turbine, theta equal to 5. So, theta is the inlet angle and 5 is the outlet angle. So, velocity of the steam at the outlet of the nozzle. So, V equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H2. So, square root of 2 into 2935 minus 2584 into 1000 equal to 837.85 meters per second. Now, we calculate for maximum efficiency, sigma equal to VB by V. So, cos alpha by 2. So, cos 20 divided by 2 equal to 0.47. So, the absolute velocity is 0.47 into 837.85 equal to 393.8 meters per second. So, that is the answer to the problem. So, we have to calculate. So, they find the blade velocity that produces maximum efficiency for the turbine speed of 3600 revolutions per minute. That is the, so 393.8 meters per second is the blade velocity. That is the answer to the problem. Next question is from 2001 question paper. Steam at 300 kilopascal, 500 degree Celsius with enthalpy of 3486 kilojoules per kilogram enters a turbine and exit to the atmosphere pressure at 350 degree Celsius where the enthalpy is 3175.8 kilojoules per kilogram. Heat losses in the turbine is 50 kilowatts and the mass flow rate is 0.25 kilograms per second. Determine the power output of the turbine if the kinetic energy and losses are negligible. So, we are given P1 equal to 300 kilopascal, T1 equal to 500 Kelvin, H1 equal to 3486 kilojoules per kilogram, temperature T2 equal to 350 degrees Celsius, H2 equal to 3175.8 kilojoules per kilogram and Q heat loss equal to minus 50 kilowatts and the mass flow rate is 50 kilogram. So, it is simply applying the steady flow energy equation. So, power output of the turbine by applying the steady flow energy equation, M into H1 minus H2 minus Q. So, M equal to 0.25 kilograms per second, H1 minus H2, 3486 minus 3175.8 minus 50 equal to 27.55 kilowatts. So, the power produced by the turbine is 27.55 kilowatts. So, thank you for watching and you please post your comments on the YouTube comments box. So, you subscribe the channel so that you will get the updated videos on the GATE question paper or the subject mentioned in the list, and you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. I will sincerely answer. So, thank you for watching. So, we will meet again in the next video with a few more problems from the GATE question paper.